The company and how exactly have why did I think of starting this? So StayFit Enterprise has been founded with a strong belief that there is a need to bring simple, familiar, no jargon food into foray in a very convenient form. Health and taste are always considered to be at the other two other ends of the spectrum. So I was saying that health and taste are considered to be at the two ends of the spectrum. We want to demystify this misconception, and we also want to create a good conception that health and taste can go together. How I started is that I am an outdoor person. I love adventure sports and I love staying fit. Nutrition has, I have always been curious about the nutrition. I have always studied nutrition as a hobby. I got to work with some interesting athletes also during this journey, and I realized that when you are outdoor or when you are out of home, there is very little option that you have if you intend to eat 100% healthy food, which means for me 100% healthy means 100% natural. There are not many products that you can say are made from 100% natural ingredients. That's where I saw a gap. And I decided to back this idea of mine by quitting my job and pursuing this passion full time. I did a lot of research. We worked with nutritionists, we worked with various athletes, the people who stay at outdoor, to figure out that, you know, what would work really well for them. That's how this whole journey had started. Today, we have sort of accepted the fact that it has to contain sugar, it has to contain the high amount of preservatives because it's packaged, so you need to have a shelf life, and we have accepted that fact. At the same time, when it comes to nutrition, there is a misconception that the nutrition can only be obtained by various fat diets, or it can be obtained by high protein diets, or it has to be supplemented. So when it comes to nutrition, you find that there is either fortified products, or there are vitamin infused products, or there are something like added protein products, which is not really true. Of course, for certain ailments, if you are deficient of something, you do need to have the products which are fortified or can supplement that deficiency. But for normal people like you and me, a good healthy combination of the ingredients and the natural food that's available is perfect. Okay, back again. Hello, is it better?
Yeah.
And with this thing in mind, we have created the recipes which are handcrafted. All our recipes are something that one you could actually make it at home. This is what we have just tried to productize and bring it into market into a very convenient form. This is a huge market. I was just telling like earlier in the earlier interview that the health food product size or the market size today in India is about 33,000 crores, and it includes a whole lot of products. It contains the packaged products, it contains the fortified drinks, it contains the fortified yogurts. But so the category that we are really stepping into is that way a very niche category. To say something that is 100% healthy with confidence and really, kind of back it up with different products that are going to come we do belong to a minority here, but we definitely want to become a majority in terms of consumption of these products when it comes to people. We are quite committed to create new products. We have an impressive product line for which we have done our research, and we will launch two more new products which will be based on the grains, which will be based on the vegetables in the next coming 1 or 2 years. We are committed to increase our brand presence, and that's what brings this today's event. We are very happy and extremely proud to have Milind Soman as our brand ambassador and stakeholder. I have to say that we couldn't have found a better brand ambassador for our product. The reason being that Milind has been a consumer of our product right when it was in the prototype stage. And he remained a consumer. He today also is a consumer, and he consumed 4 bars this morning. So to go for Milind, or let's say ask Milind to be a part of this, was just, it was actually a no-brainer. With our brand agency Carination, when we were trying to write the core values for the brand and we were trying to create a positioning, we were just thinking that if brand were to be a person, who would that be? And you know the answer now. So I think about the Milind's association with the brand, I will leave it to Milind to talk about it.
Thank you, Shilpa, and welcome to all of you here today. I'm really happy to be here. I must tell you that the first time I noticed this this bar and Shilpa Phadke was about 3 years ago in Pune at an event, and I went to this stall and I tasted this bar. At that time it was really, really basic. It was wrapped in a kind of butter paper, no proper packaging. So like it had come right out of the kitchen, and it was there in the store, and I ate it, and it was really delicious. And I said to Shilpa at that time, what are you going to do with this product? And of course at that time I think she had no clear idea. Of course the idea has grown in her head and it's developed and it's really mature now, but at that time it was like, okay, we're still experimenting, we're still redefining and, you know, refining the product. And I asked her at that time, do you need any investment? Because I was really excited by it, because it's very rare that you really find something of quality and value in the commercial space. It's very, very rare. And also to find the kind of idealism and conviction that backs that 100%. You know, there's always some kind of loophole, or you see some kind of gap somewhere, but here it was 100%, and I was really impressed. And I wanted to be part of it at that time, but Shilpa said no. So that was, I said, okay, fine, we'll see what happens in the future. I wished her all the best and all of that. But I started eating this bar quite regularly. So this bar, as Shilpa has mentioned, is not for primarily for sports people. It's not for runners, it's not for cyclists, even though it's called On The Run. It's for people who are on the run. And as she mentioned, I had 4 bars this morning. It's because I just landed from a flight and drove here directly for this press conference. I had another meeting downstairs before this press conference started. So with that kind of a schedule, for me to really eat what I would have loved to eat and what is my staple, which would have been a lot of fresh fruits and so on, if that becomes impossible, then this is definitely the next best thing for me. So I would, even if I was not a part of this initiative, I would have started thinking, where am I going to get my On The Run bar? And so many times I've called Shilpa and said, you know, I need a box, where will I get it? Because I'm spoiled and I don't want to look online and find out where it's available, call the owner of the company and say, I want a box of bars. And Shilpa would of course make sure that I got it. But I've been using these bars especially on long runs. I've done a lot of long runs over the last few years. Some of you may know I run from city to city. I love running on the highway. And On The Run is always part of the nutrition plan, and that's fabulous that I can have access to something like this, because to me, somebody who believes in natural whole food, and I believe in it because I know it's good for my body, and I know that there are other products out there that are more synthesized, more synthetic, and they give you short-term benefit, but I know that they're not good in the long term for my body, so I won't use them. It was really wonderful to have access to something like this. So just to give you an idea, when I did Ironman in 2015, my nutrition plan was some ragi, which is a cereal, in powder form with some jaggery. I used to fill that in my cycling bottle on the cycle, and every time I needed some nutrition, I would add water to it, shake it and drink it. Yes, Ashok, listening. So when I tell that to other athletes today, they're a little shocked, because there's so many products that are marketed today that are more convenient, faster, quicker, packaged better. But to me, those are not the important things. The important things is, on the whole, in the long run, what is good for you? Because to me, it's not about performance at that moment, it's about my health. My health takes priority over anything else. Because I know as I grow older, okay, I said it, as I grow older, I really need to be more careful about my health. And if I'm careful now, it's never too early to start being careful. So I would like it that even parents understand that they should encourage their children to eat healthy, and not fun, and not for entertainment, and not just because the child is having a tantrum. You know, parents must make it a priority to make sure that children develop healthy habits. So even bars like this, which are, in fact, as Shilpa mentioned, that sometimes people think that health and taste are at two opposite ends of the spectrum. But here, as soon as I tasted this bar, and I think the one I tasted that time was, I think you had the oats and apricot, right? And this is still today my favorite, the oats and apricot and the prune and raisin. That's why I'm there on this side. And, you know, I was really shocked that I know that, you know, when you eat something that's healthy, it'll be a little bit bland or a little bit, you know, not so interesting, but these were absolutely delicious. And what happens is when you eat them, even psychologically, you know you're eating something that is good for you. It makes you feel good. And that is something that we need. There's so much stress, I believe, in our everyday lives. We are accumulating that stress. We're not dealing with it effectively. We're not dealing with it efficiently. But when we make these small decisions to take care of ourselves, we take these small decisions to make the right choices, and they might be a little bit more effort, but they're the right choices, psychologically we feel that we're doing something good for ourselves, and the stress levels can come down. I have experienced that myself. So whenever I eat something that I know is healthy, I feel good, and that feel good factor lasts the entire day. So I'm really happy to be here. Thank you, Shilpa, for finally agreeing to allow me to be part of this. And I think this product is going to do really well. We are going to try our best to inform the public on the differences that they need to know. And if you see on the package, there is a small mnemonic that says read the label, and that is something that has become very widely promoted across the world, that you have to be careful about what you eat. You have to read the label, check out the ingredients, what is actually in this food that you're going to eat. And it's not easy. You know, for so many years people have not been reading labels. They've just been saying, okay, there's a label there, it tastes good, let's eat it. If it's been sanctioned by the government or it's been sanctioned by the authorities, it's obviously good for us. But that's not so obvious anymore. There are a lot of products we know that contain ingredients, and that comes out in the media from time to time saying, oh, this causes cancer, this causes allergic reactions, this causes this and this causes that, because these are synthesized elements that you know, a lot of people are not comfortable with, and they are added generally to all kinds of products. So it's very important to read the label. And what is important is that what is said, that is important, that if you understand what it is, it's probably safe for you. If you don't know what this ingredient is, you should not eat it. And it's still difficult to convince people. It's like when I'm talking about ragi, which is a very simple cereal, it's a millet. We talk about ragi and people will start asking me, oh, so is ragi good for this? Is it good for that? How safe is it? How much can I eat? If I eat this much, will it be good for me? If I eat that much, can I mix it with this? I said, when you eat a pizza, you don't ask that many questions. You know? Because this is something that is marketed to you so beautifully. Pizzas and all the other packaged food that you and the fast foods that you find, that they tell you that it's good for you, it's going to enhance your life, you're going to have fun and it's great, and you know, all of those things. And we are brainwashed into believing all that. So So when somebody comes and tells you ek bajri ka roti khao, you look at it suspiciously and say, really? Isse kya hota hai? I said, you know, your ancestors have been eating this. They are fitter. They were fitter. They were healthier than you. We had less diseases at that time. Less stress. More productive lives. And this is what they were eating. So the other rule of thumb for me, when people ask me, what is it that we should eat? Like, of all the options that are available. Because people sometimes get fed up. You know, ye mat khao, ye khao, ye khane se ye hota hai, wo khane se wo hota hai. So what do you finally eat? So one thing is, of course, you read the label. If you understand what is on the label, it's probably okay to eat it. The other thing is, what your grandparents ate is definitely good for you. What is local, what was not imported, what was not out of season, what they got very, very easily where they were, is probably very, very good for you. So very two very simple things. And those are the things you need to follow if you want to have a healthy diet. What else can I say about Shilpa? No, again, I'm really, really happy to be here. And I'm very excited that today Shilpa is going to show me how to make a bar. And that is also to show you how easy it is to make it. There is nothing that you can't see or don't know that goes into this bar. So we're going to actually make this bar, which is in this package. Not prune and raisin. Okay, figure date. So we're going to make the figure date bar, which is in that box. The same bar. She's going to tell me how to make it. I'm not going to make it at home. I'm still going to take it from the box. But just for you to know how simple and easy it is, that anybody can actually make this at home. There is no magic about it. It's just that we are packaging it so it's easier for you to access, so that you don't have to go to the market and make it yourself. But you can. You can do it. It's like when people want to say, how can I do Ironman? Or how do I run a marathon? It's not that you really need a structured program or a coach or somebody to tell you, do this and don't do that. People have been running for millions of years. They've been running distances much more than we can even imagine. You can do it on your own. But having a coach makes it easier. This is the same principle. I mean, this is something that you can make at home, but you can also buy from us. And you better buy it from us. Alright, so now we're going to show you how to make the fig and date bar.
Sir, what do you eat? I think we have answered that question
she's
today.
She's the only woman who said no to me. And she's the first woman to get me to MBA.
Very nice.
Two records.
Super. It'll go down in the history, Shilpa.
So what do we have here?
Okay, so we have, so these are the ones which we have chopped. But we have basically dates, we have dry figs, we have roasted almonds, we have rice crispy, we have orange, and we have salt and cinnamon. So basically everything that you see, this girl is made out. She's got orange rings and she dates.
Excuse me.
So no preservatives, and more importantly, which I consider very important, is no refined sugar. Okay?
So can you please wear the gloves?
Gloves also. Okay, it might have some extra salt, that's all.
We manufactured in an ISO 22000 facility. Whoa. So.
So I hope here everyone likes dates and figs. Dates and figs. Okay. Anybody who doesn't like dates and figs? You don't like dates and figs? You don't like?
I don't like dates.
You don't like dates? We'll pick up dates.
This is the best
bar. You like?
So Melinda is now going to put together the ingredients. Just put the dates.
The chopped dates.
Then you are going to put the chopped figs. Yeah, all of it.
Okay. No, all of it.
It's measured.
It's measured, alright. So how much is it? Like half a kilo?
No. And we are going to use your punch to actually mix it. So here is anjeer. This is the roasted almond powder. So now you have to start mixing the ingredients together.
What
about the rice? Go for it, Milan.
So once you have mixed it, we are also going to put some orange rind.
So which was the first bar that you conceptualized? What was the flavor? This one?
I think this is the first bar I thought of was Fig and Date actually.
So this is the original?
This is the original. And the second bar that I thought of was Oat and Apricot.
Oat and Apricot. So that's currently my favorite, but I just want to tell you, should I tell them now?
Yeah, I think Milind has some bright ideas about the new product launch.
Of course, we're going to have a much larger range. The range is continuously expanding. But what I have asked for specifically for myself, because my staple is khichdi. I eat khichdi every day. I have asked to make a khichdi bar. So it's going to be on the run khichdi bar, which will have in it khaske pohe, which is of course over here, which is rice. And it will have lentils, different kinds of lentils, which lentils are dal for those who don't know.
So on a on a serious note, we
don't
definitely So we definitely intend to bring something which uses lentils and vegetables and some other natural ingredients.
So basically, she doesn't want to hold the khichdi bar, but I want to hold the khichdi bar.
It has to sell.
It will.
I will sell it.
Especially the mothers will try to feed khichdi to the kids.
But that is the objective.
I said if I eat khichdi all the time and I want to carry the khichdi in my pocket, I need a khichdi bar.
That's right, yeah. So incidentally, I have come across a bhel bar once on the Bangalore airport.
Bhel bar?
Yeah. So can I just do this?
Oh, you want to do it?
Yeah,
I think it's the good one.
Yeah, I think so.
The woman's touch.
Come on, you can't sit. This gender kind of thing.
So tell me, Milind, what other than the khichdi bar you intend in terms of products? I mean, energy bar is one thing, but what is the product line that you think we should have in mind for expansion of the range?
You want to give it all today?
No, I think give some of those.
Let's digest the khichdi bar first. Okay. I mean, I can do this all day, but...
Hold on, but seriously, how long is it going to take?
It's just going to take...
They're all hungry.
Yeah,
it's lunchtime. And they're all on the run. They need to have this bar. So how does it stick? Just because of the dates?
Yeah, it just sticks because of the dates. We have the mixer, which are called a hand mixer. Which picks just like this in a hand, but it has a motor, which I don't have. So when it mixes, it just forms into a clump. We have sheeters which convert it into a sheet and the cutters to cut it. So it's as simple as that. I'm just going to take a small portion of this.
You put this
oil? Yeah, I did.
And cinnamon?
Yes. While you were mixing it.
And this is how you made it for the first time at home.
Yeah, that's right.
So I think, of course, that it's really important that through something like this, we can understand that it's not really inconvenient to eat healthy. It's not necessary that you can't make interesting things. I mean, there are lots of things being made today in the world that are interesting, that are tasty and healthy together. We don't know about them, and we want to promote even other products like this. Maybe they're not even made by us, but we want to create a range of things that are available that people should know about. It doesn't matter whether we are making them or somebody else is making them. The whole idea is to change the mindset of people, because people think that today it's such a very fast life, you need that convenience, otherwise you're going to be left behind or something like that. Or you've been told that you have to eat this kind of food, or you need these supplements, or you need to eat this much protein, or you need to eat that this much carbohydrate. And you know, the best thing for the body, according to me, as a sports person, and I've been doing sports since I was 9 years old, the best thing for the body is to eat whole natural food. You don't have to even think about calories. You don't have to think about carbohydrates. You don't have to think about proteins or fibers, because every whole food you eat has all of these elements in it in a very, very balanced way. So nature, you cannot do better than nature. You really can't. I mean, we try to do better than nature. We try to make things think, okay, we compromised a little bit on nature because we wanted it to be convenient. But I think that when we try to make things convenient, they may not necessarily be good for us, and we've lost all the value that nature intended. So, add on the run, you're interrupting.
Sorry. So, what I was saying, there are a lot of ingredients that our traditional kitchens have used, which have kind of disappeared from our lives. Like, but when the Western world really talks of it, like flax seeds or something, we suddenly realize that we need to eat that. But we don't have it to eat it in a such a boring form as drinking the water with flax seeds. I mean, flax seeds has been present in our lives in the form of dabsachi chutney. For all along, I mean, with your grandmother.
Dabsachi chutney.
Yeah, I'm sure you didn't know this. So, ask any Maharashtrian around and he would know. So, these are the ingredients that I think need to find a way back into our lives. Since we cannot find a way in our lives in our routine, so we are going to help you out do that.
And of course, a lot of people have asked me when I mentioned to them, you know, this is what we are doing. They said, you know, what is the competition? You know, who what are the other bars here or the other food products here that are competing with this?
No, it's for
you. But I can taste it and say, wow. Yeah. Wow.
And we have here, if you have been in front of you, the same fig and date bar that is in this package. See? Yeah. There's no magic.
And we would like you actually to taste this one, and we would also want you to taste this one to really see that it just tastes the same, except for the freshness of the orange.
Mobile.
Serve you. You can. Can you take like half? Yeah, you know something.
You're not allergic to this. Just taste a small bit, like this much. See, wow.
Wow.
Okay, anybody here?
Yeah.
So, you know, here is the original one, just so that you can see.
Ah, thank you. How's it?
Wow. So, it was less price because we couldn't crush it here. Thanks, Milan. Thank you very much for learning this bar from me.
And now we're ready to do questions. Any questions you might have?
Please. You can remove your apron.
One picture with the product.
So, no, wait.
So one more.
So one more. Last one.
Another?
Zara, sir.
Thank you very much. So, as he said, we are ready to take the question.
Any question?
Lower parade. कल पता नहीं अभी तक
उन्हें डाका नहीं एमबीसी में डाका
है अच्छा तेरे को
ओके वेर ओके टेकिंग क्वेश्चंस दैट यू डोंट आस्क एज अ पब्लिशिंग हाउस बट एज अ पर्सन इंडिविजुअली यू वांट टू नो अबाउट न्यूट्रिशन यू वांट टू नो सीरियसली इफ यू डू then Shilpa is really, really well informed, very knowledgeable. We would like you to ask those questions because they can help, the answers can help everybody. Yeah. So, of course, it can be related to your publication, but also it can be a personal question, if you don't mind.
Hi, the first question that I have is for you. It's not really. It's okay, yeah. Is this a one-off investment for you, or are you going to also further invest in health-related products?
Who is the question for?
For you.
Oh, for me?
Yeah.
It depends, yes. I mean, in fact, I am looking at
Mike.
That is like an app.
Right now, so not necessarily a food product. But an app is something that I am currently developing, and that might be the next thing that I have. But in terms of food products, like I said, it's very rare to find something like this that has the conviction and has that 100% value that I would back, because it's something that I believe in. It's something that I'm looking for to use myself. It's basically something that I have been experiencing over the last few years. People have become so interested in health and fitness, which they weren't earlier. As you know, in India, we don't have a culture of health, fitness, sports, exercise. We don't even know the difference between health and fitness. But people have been asking me a lot of questions, especially on social media. I have quite a large following, and I never answer anybody. So I said, if there was a space where they could ask me, and I could maybe not answer even myself, I'll answer some, but I have a team who will answer questions based on the philosophy that I live by, then it might be something that is useful. So there are many apps like this that are out there, but none are fronted by a person who is, say, a sports person or an athlete that people do look up to. Kuch? They want to have one-on-one interaction. Okay. You want to know anything about lunch or dinner or anything?
You have 4 bars since morning. How many bars can you have in a day?
Whoa! How many bars can I have in a day? Like as a challenge?
So
obviously, because I'm talking about whole natural food, I believe in a balanced diet. So I wouldn't want to eat only on the run bars the whole day. So my how I start my day is, for those who haven't seen the video of Aap Kya Khate Ho, is lots and lots of fresh fruits, and almost 2-2.5-3 kilos of fruit is what I eat. But if I don't get that, so for me, even this is a packaged product. For me to eat fresh is the best. Right? But if I don't get that, and that is why it's called on the run. When I'm too busy to get that, why did I have the 4 bars? Because I just couldn't get what I really wanted. And this is something that I trust. You know, if I can't get that, then this is what I will trust for my body. So that is it.
But like, I love this. Can I just have my day only with bars?
You can, but the thing is they're very, very rich. You know, they have a lot of vitamins, a lot of minerals, a lot of, they're very potent in terms of nutrition.
Ideally, maybe a 1 or 2 per day is recommended.
That's Shilpa. She's a nutritionist.
More importantly, can this supplement lunch or dinner?
So the answer is no. So if someone tells you that you can eat a bar for lunch or dinner, that's not right. Because
but
you need
also,
to have...
There are people who eat a pizza for lunch.
So for them, the bar is the next better choice.
Because what we say is, when you're talking about a balanced diet, if you see like Indian food, we have a thali, right? Basic Indian food is a thali. Like not in the weddings I'm talking about.
Everyday kind of food is a thali, where you have a vegetable or two vegetables, you have a dal, you have, you know, a salad or something like that, and rice, and you have the chapati or something. So that constitutes a balanced meal. It has got everything that your body probably needs as nutrition. So if you're not going to get that, then this becomes a standby, a substitute. So it's a substitute. This cannot become your meal, and it cannot become the only thing that you eat. Like for example, there are diets like fruitarian diets, like people who eat only fruits, they don't eat anything else, but they then still have to supplement with vitamins or minerals that they don't get through foods. Which means that a fruitarian diet is not enough. Right? So the human being is omnivorous. We have evolved as a species that gathers food, and we are probably the species that eats the biggest, largest variety of food of any other animal on the planet. we can eat anything and digest anything, and our bodies can use it. So we need that kind of variety. We have evolved to require that kind of variety so that the body can take what it needs.
This mainly fits the mid-meal category. So the products that we plan to come up with always fit this mid-meal category, which means that when you are delaying your meals or when you are not able to get access to your meals or your food, that is when you consume, and then you must see that you consume something which is natural and healthy and not go for the junk food at that time. Yeah, so we also have the cereals which are made from the fruit juices in the market. These are available, the Andhran granolas. We plan to do some innovative packaging to these products so that these can also be consumed on the run. So we do have many products, and I think our challenge today is to bring it in a form that stays with our objective of getting healthy food while you are on the go. And that's what the granola will do. So, first of all, if you already, obviously, since you want to make a transition, which means that there is something, some part of your life which is not, you don't believe that it is in the health, it's healthy. So, it's the way of cutting either on the junk foods or cutting, if you are delaying your meals, if that is bringing unhealthiness into your life, this definitely is going to help you do that. If you happen to be a traveler and you have to eat on like flights and the food that is not healthy, then probably till you have an access to a good sumptuous meal, this is going to help you do that, because those are the times when junk food really enters the life. In terms of habit, I think everybody chooses for itself that okay, how exactly you want to make a change to the healthy living. And yes, you definitely need healthy food as a very essential element of that healthy lifestyle.
So you can have 4 bars a day?
Yeah, you surely can have 4 bars a day. The thing is that it's nothing other than carbohydrates. And also, if you, for example, if I have to take oats and apricot, it has got oats, it's apricot, there is honey and there is butter. So if at all, it again, there is calorie mention on that. So if you were to give you an example, if you are going to eat one plate of poha, which is roughly 225 calories, and you don't have time to make poha, then you eat 2 bars, that's possible. But as a practice, these are definitely the mid-meal category. So you must eat your lunch at the time. But if you are going to skip the lunch, then don't eat a pizza, probably eat a bar. So there's no harm in eating 4, but as he said, these are very high, these are made of dry fruits. These are high in vitamins and minerals and carbohydrates. So you have to see that if that is your requirement for the day. If you eat just 4 bars, it's fine. But it's like that patient who eats after having a meal, then you cannot have 4 bars. And that is why we are not going to restrict to the energy bars. That's just the first product that we have. We are coming up with products which will be a little more lighter, which will have ingredients which are different than the ones which we have in the bar. So you could actually get a variety of ingredients through our products into your meat. Yes, exactly. I mean, almonds, figs, we have always known that these need to be consumed. It's just that in our life we don't find a time to consume it on a regular basis. So eat one fig and date bar and you would have eaten at least 3-4 of the dry fruits.
That's it. Thank you.
Yeah, we just need to thank. So thank you very much. I think we are waiting for her to give us a schedule for 1 to 1. Thanks a lot for coming, and please do enjoy the starters and lunch, and please do not go without taking our goodie bags, which has got all 6 flavors of our energy bar. Thank you.
तो ये जो प्रोडक्ट है ऑन द रन वो मैंने पहली बार 3-4 साल पहले देखा था
उस वक्त भी मैंने पूछा कि मुझे लाइक पार्टनरशिप की जरूरत है उसे आगे लेने के लिए लाइक द प्रोडक्ट सो मच और आई स्टार्टेड ईटिंग दिस बार सिंस देन एंड आई ईट इट रेगुलरली तो उस वक्त उन्होंने मना किया उन्होंने सर वी डोंट नीड एनी इन्वेस्टमेंट राइट नाउ बस पार्टनरशिप की जरूरत नहीं वी स्टिल वर्किंग आउट कि आगे क्या करना है कैसे डेवलप करना है एक्सपेरिमेंट्स भी काफ़ी चल रहे थे and so I was really happy that this year she came back to me and she said you know we are growing a lot very fast now we're in so many stores in Bombay and Maharashtra and here and there and I said and said that you know we really would like you to be part of this ki aap agar isme agar is waqt shamil ho to mujhe bahut acha lage and of course I was very happy because I've been using the product I've been eating these bars I think they're absolutely amazing and that's why we're here today to for the official launch of the new packaging
hum karna hai
तो इसमें जो 6 फ्लेवर्स हैं ऑल ऑफ देम आर डिफरेंट एंड आर रियली एक्साइटिंग बट माय फेवरेट इज़ द प्रून एंड रेज़िन दिस इज़ माय फेवरेट एंड ऑल्सो दिस आई हैव टू बेसिकली एंड दिस वन व्हिच इज़ द ओट एंड एप्रिकॉट ये और जो पहली बार जब मैंने ये बार को टेस्ट किया था आई थिंक इट वॉज दिस ओट्स एंड एप्रिकॉट इट्स स्टिल स्टिल टुडे वन ऑफ माई फेवरेट्स a lot of things I've started also another couple of companies for other products that are based on health and based on fitness and so on so I'm quite busy doing things like that a lot of events jo meri companies karti hain jo mera foundation karta hai united sisters foundation jo pinkathon organize karta hai so I travel a lot Hot summer, so I think my favorite food during summer is cucumbers. I think it's a very nutritious fruit. It's very high in water content, and I eat a lot of cucumbers during summer. And I think it's good to eat a lot of fresh fruits and fresh vegetables in summer, just to keep cool and to keep hydrated, and make sure your body has enough nutrition that it requires.